We have a train horn kit from trainhorndeliver.com. Comes with everything you need to install it. Comes with a compressor and a 2-gallon air tank, your train horns, 15 feet of air hose, wires, all your connectors and hardware to install, and switches, rubber grommets and everything for vibration. You're gonna need a drill and a set of sockets probably to install this. We're gonna go ahead and put it on a 2011 Ford F-250. You're going to want to find somewhere to mount these train horns and your air compressor. On our truck, it's actually going to be lifted and our spare tire won't be utilized. It'll be too small. So we're going to go ahead and mount it up underneath where the spare tire is normally mounted. We're going to mount our horns. Took our spare tire down, it's out of our way. We found a location right here where we're going to stick our horns up. And we'll bolt them right here. Comes with a foam pad for vibration. Put that on first before you stick them up there. After we mounted our air horns, we got the air compressor in the tank, mounted that to the frame here on the side, ran our wires down along the frame to power our compressor and our solenoid for our horns. Now we're gonna go and make the connections for the power to the compressor and to the solenoid for the horns. When we're done with that, we'll run our air hose. Okay, we're gonna make our final electrical connections back here to our compressor and our air horn solenoid. We're gonna use some shrink wrap connectors just to make sure there's no corrosion in any of our connections. All our electrical connections are done. We're going to run our air hose. We went ahead, we put our fitting into the solenoid valve here. You take your air hose and stick it in. It's a compression fitting. Real easy to do. Run your air hose over and make your connection right onto your air tank. Just make sure there's nothing that's really going to rub this hose that's sharp, because you don't want that hose to bust. Now that we're done back here, we're going to go up front into the cab. We're going to make the connections for our electric to our switches for the compressor and our air horn solenoid. We ran all our wires in the cab, connected all our switches. Our compressor is hooked to one of our upfitter switches, so we can run our compressor, and the compressor will pump and shut off when it's got enough PSI built up in it. Our horns, we ran two switches. We ran a safety switch so we don't accidentally bump our horn, and then we ran our horn to trigger our switch. Now our horn will run if this switch isn't on. Now we're going to go ahead and test out our train horns and show you how loud they really are.